If you got to this video, that means you have probably watched a lot of videos about data science roadmap and how you can become a data scientist. And this video will focus on mistakes that you should be avoiding while learning to become a data scientist. These learnings are based on my experience in the industry over the last 10 years working in the data science domain, and especially becoming a data scientist in a non-traditional way. This is the first thing that you should avoid. In the journey of becoming data scientists, there will be many people who will tell you to start with coding, whether that is Python or something else. I completely disagree with that advice. Coding is a tool to apply data science. It is not data science in itself. And I've seen many people make this mistake where they will jump into coding, start learning Python, start learning SQL, and they think like this is the right way to approach it. Okay, maybe it is the right way to approach it if you are very new to coding and you have no background and you just want to see like if coding is something that you even enjoy because it's such a big part of data science. But what data science actually is statistics and machine learning. That's the core knowledge that a data scientist need to know, and coding is a tool that how a data scientist will apply statistics and machine learning. So I'm going to say this again. Coding is a tool to apply statistics and machine learning in data science. It is not data science in itself. So what I would like you to do is start learning the fundamentals in statistics and machine learning and math, and see if this is something that you enjoy doing. Because if you start doing that and you realize that you don't enjoy it, then I would want you to stop learning. Coding languages such as Python, SQL, R are very powerful languages that you can learn as a data scientist. But these are just tools to apply data science. Second, and this is one of my biggest pet peeves, and I'm gonna say it. A lot of people believe that they need to become a data analyst before becoming a data scientist. This is not true. You do not need to become a data analyst before becoming a data scientist. Okay, I'm gonna say this again. You don't need to become a data analyst before becoming a data scientist. And I think this is such a big misunderstanding that a lot of people have. They will jump right into data analytics. They will learn all the skills that you need to have as a data analytics, whether that is like data analysis, learning SQL, building dashboards. Yes, data scientists and data analysts have a lot of concepts that they have in common, but data science is more than that. For example, as a data analyst, you're gonna be spending a lot of time building dashboards. As a data scientist, you will likely not be using that skill set. Additionally, as a data scientist, you require a lot more statistics and machine learning knowledge. If you choose to become a data analyst, you're gonna miss out on a lot of time that you could have spent on learning concepts in statistics and machine learning to solidify your knowledge. You could have used that time to build projects in data science. You could have also used that time to get experiences, whether that's internships, personal projects, and whatnot. So if your end goal is to become a data scientist, please reconsider your decision to become a data analyst first. Yes, there are many people who will transition from data analyst to data scientist, completely fine. And it's okay for people who don't know that they want to become a data scientist, but later they realize they want to become a data scientist, totally fine. It's easier to make a transition from data analyst to data scientist. Of course, it requires a lot of work, but if your end goal is to become a data scientist, then start with that roadmap. One of my recent videos talks you through the entire data scientist roadmap, so definitely watch that. I'm gonna link it somewhere here. Number three is the mistake that I personally made. When I started in the data science domain, I jumped right into the data scientist role. At that time, I did not know that there are so many other roles that existed. There is machine learning engineer, AI engineer, data analyst, data engineer, although I did work as a data engineer for some time, but that's a different story. Many other roles that exist in the data science domain, including a recent one, AI product manager, which is a booming topic lately. Okay, so what I'm trying to say is that don't be me, don't be Sundas. If you want to get into data science, don't just jump into one career right away. Try to understand what different careers do. What does a data analyst do? What does a machine learning engineer do? Maybe there is a role that you will learn about and realize like, no, this sounds actually more interesting to me and that's what I want to pursue. So like do your research before deciding and jumping into one, picking one and moving forward with it, because it's going to take a lot of work and you want to be sure that this is exactly what you want to do before you put in a lot of work. The fourth mistake that I see a lot of people make when trying to learn data science is not following a plan. And this goes to my first mistake where you just jump right into learning to code. Sure, that's fine. It's great. It's better than doing nothing, right? But if you want to become a data scientist, just make sure that you are going forward with a plan. Create a plan, create a roadmap. And one of the things that I would highly recommend is for you to work backward. This is something that I personally have done in my personal projects, in my interview prep, apps and in my job search and whatnot. Figure out your target company, your target role, what you want to work as. Then figure out what does a data scientist, let's say at Meta, does. Then look at the job description for somebody who works at Meta. Then look at the job description for an open role at Meta for a data scientist role. Understand what the requirements are. Then go to LinkedIn and find somebody who is working as a data scientist at Meta or have worked as a data scientist at Meta. Look at their projects, look at their education, try to understand what type of work they do, what kind of background they have. This will give you a really good understanding and will help you define your roadmap that you would need to follow in order to become a data scientist. So make sure when you're starting to learn data science, you go with a plan. That will help you make sure that you stay on track and you follow it. Put it on your calendar, whatever you need to do, allocate whatever time you need to allocate over the weekend, after work, during day, whatever you need to do, like make sure you're creating a plan and following it. On the topic of creating a plan, I found this Intro to Python ebook, which is basically a beginner guide to learning Python for data analysis. This ebook is created by HubSpot, who is also sponsoring this portion of the video. The ebook covers libraries such as Pandas, NumPy, Matplotlib, which are some of the essential libraries for analyzing data with Python. It also walks you through basic ideas and gives you coding snippets so you can plug and play. It is available to download free, and I'm linking it in the description below. Now let's talk about the next thing that you should be avoiding while learning to become a data scientist. The fifth mistake that you should avoid is expecting to land a job after learning these things. Over the last few months and years, job market has become, what is the right word? Stressful? Job market has become stressful, and it takes a lot more than just learning how to code to land a job. I like to think of landing a job as a project in itself, just like learning these skills is a project in itself. Let's say you're able to do regression analysis using Python, but you go into a coding interview, you're in a time pressure setting, there are another person sitting in front of you, and it's possible that you might forget. So in order to truly be successful in these job interview scenarios, you need to practice. You need to practice it as much as you can. And I like to break data science into three buckets. One is coding, which a lot of people spend a lot of time on. It's one of the buckets. There's other elements. Second is behavioral questions. And third, which I, in my opinion, is very important, is statistics and machine learning fundamentals, where you will get a lot of hypothetical scenario-based questions. So make sure you're treating job search as a project and fully dedicating time, building your portfolio, building your projects that you can speak about in your interviews, and also going into the interview with a lot of prep. The sixth mistake that you should avoid is my favorite. Generative AI. Generative AI is one of the most transformative technology that we have seen in over the last decade in tech, data science, and beyond. So don't avoid it while you're learning these skills. Make sure that you're leveraging generative AI to your advantage, whether that is helping generative AI teach you new concepts or working on a project and having ChatGPT write basic code for you. I have done a few videos on ChatGPT and actually have a playlist on how to use generative AI, specifically ChatGPT, Bard, and other tools for coding and data analysis. You can watch it somewhere here. So take generative AI seriously and make it part of your curriculum. Then number eight mistakes is moving beyond regression. And this is going to counter the first thing that I mentioned. Regression is one of the most important concepts in data science. It is often that we spend a lot of time on these concepts, on learning regression, on learning classification, and so on. But there's a lot more to data science than that. In order to be a great data scientist, you need to have good domain knowledge, good business understanding, good PMing understanding, PMing as in like product management and product development lifecycle, and good communication. So regression is important. Learning these fundamentals and concepts are important. But how do you put that into the real world where you're going to be working with a lot of different stakeholders in different domains? How do you communicate your findings, your results, your insights, or how do you even understand what the business needs? So having a good understanding of all of these things around the data science umbrella will help you be successful in your career. So when you're defining your curriculum, make sure that you're incorporating these things into your learning plan. Ninth, math is important, but not really. Okay, this might be controversial, but the reason I say this, math is definitely important, but that also depends on what kind of data scientist you're going to be. If you're going to be a data scientist who is going to be developing custom machine learning models, math is your friend and you should be knowing math in and out. But if you are going to be a data scientist who is using machine learning models that are already built, for example, regression analysis, classification model, and you're not building your own custom machine learning models, math is important still, but not as much. So understand where you fall in the spectrum of how much math you need to know so you don't fall into that trap. And finally, my last and my biggest tip is do not fall into tutorial trap. When I say tutorials, I basically mean you watching a YouTube video or you watching a video on the course. Yes, those are all all important. And it is often that when you watch it, for example, maybe you're watching this video and you're like, yes, I get it. I get all 10 points. But in order to apply them in practice, it's way more difficult. Similarly, when you're watching these tutorials, let's say you're watching a tutorial in Python, it looks very easy. It looks very straightforward. You finish that tutorial and you're like, yes, I got it. I can do it. But when you actually start applying these on a real project, on real data set, on your computer, the chances are that you're going to run into issues. So this is called tutorial trap because you watch the video and you moved on. Don't move on right away. Spend some time doing the hands-on work, understanding the concept in more detail before you move on, because the chances are that when you do it yourself, you're going to run into issues. When you run into issues, you learn more. And running into issues is actually not bad. So that's why you need to do more hands-on work. So it sticks with you, the knowledge sticks with you, and you're not becoming target of tutorial trap. Okay, so these were the 10 things that I wanted to mention. Is there anything else that you would like to share? Let me know in comments. And if you like this video, maybe I'll see you in the next one. Have a great day. Bye.